You're watching 8 News Now at 11.
It's been nearly a year since a 3-year-old girl went missing. Her parents are accused of murder, but her body's never been found.
And the I-Team has been trying to piece together this case. Vanessa Murphy now with more.
The only people who may have known what happened to 3-year-old Zaela Walker are her parents, Lakia Walker and Ricky Beasley. They're in jail, accused of murder, while Zaela has never been found.
Everybody think I did this, period.
This is audio obtained by the I-Team from the murder case. It is a recording of a conversation between Ricky and Lakia.
When I'm found, when I turn myself in, everybody gonna know that, nah, Lakia ain't no victim. Lakia up here.
Just chill.
Activity.
But that's chill. This is simple. All you gotta do from here, you said it at the beginning. Nobody, no case.
But later in this 30-minute conversation, they speak about Zaela like she's alive.
That's all she wants is her mama.
Lakia refers to Zaela as being with the mother of Ricky's other child.
Zaela is already with Brianna. I just need you to go be with them, and y'all do what the f*** you need to do for my daughter. That's it. We don't got nothing to talk about.
But Brianna Young told police she never had Zaela, and that's a recurring theme of this case. Police say both Ricky and Lakia changed their stories about who Zaela was with. And then when police contacted those people, they said they never had Zaela.
If I could say I was in a movie, and the script was against me, but it was well written. This is one of the best well written scripts ever.
Here's how police say the events unfolded. Ricky Beasley wasn't in Zaela's life much during her first 2 years. By the summer of 2018, he was spending time with her. On August 15th, detectives say Zaela was with Ricky while Lakia went to a job interview. At noon, they met at Sandstone Ridge Park in North Las Vegas, and Ricky refused to give Zaela back. Lakia then stayed in front of Ricky's home where he lived with his mother and called 911 and 311 to get her child back. In the days that followed, text messages reveal how Lakia begged Ricky for Zaela and expressed concern about a doctor's appointment for Zaela since a doctor pointed out a swollen lymph node. Ricky demanded money. 13 bands, meaning $13,000. Lakia said she'd work as a stripper to raise the money. On August 21st, Ricky's mother later told police she heard a thump and then saw Ricky carrying Zaela to the bathtub for a shower. He claimed she urinated and he threw a cot because he was mad. According to police, that would be the last day anyone other than Ricky or Lakia saw Zaela alive. The next day, Ricky would do a Google search on treating seizures, including whether marijuana would help. He then went to Reef Dispensary and purchased a joint. The night of August 22nd, he and Lakia met at Craig Ranch Park, where she left her cell phone, her wallet, and car. And they left in Ricky's mother's car, making a stop near Mount Charleston before leaving town. On September 17th, they came back to Las Vegas for money and left again. On September 23rd, they were stopped at Mexico's border. They then continued traveling through multiple states. On November 16th, they were stopped in Texas, where they tried to start a new life. On November 30th, North Las Vegas police asked for help to find the parents and child. On December 1st, Lakia and Ricky were spotted at a North Las Vegas casino. Ricky was arrested on March 15th, so was Lakia. Ricky's mother later changed her story, according to a prosecutor, describing the timing of that thump differently, saying it occurred after Zaela was already in the shower. She also told police she kept her car clean. Remember, that's what Ricky was driving when the couple skipped town. Lakia said during the couple's travels, there was a terrible smell in the trunk she tried to get rid of. Detectives make it clear. Ricky lied about Zayla's whereabouts, and Lakia, who begged to be with her daughter, suddenly showed a lack of concern after August 22nd. She didn't even call her daughter for her third birthday. A detective says Lakia described the couple's road trip as her opportunity to be free and live her own life, while it's unclear what happened to her own child.
I'm out here ruining lives, and I ruined Zayla's life. Zayla don't need me in her life.
Vanessa Murphy, 8 News Now.
The I-team reached out to the Clark County District Attorney's Office to clarify the origination of that recording between Lakia and Ricky, but the DA's office would not comment. Now, we have put the entire recording on our website at LasVegasNow.com for you to hear.
Both Lakia Walker and Ricky Beasley denied our request for interviews. They are both awaiting trial. We also reached out to the ex-girlfriend of Ricky and both of the defendant's mothers, who did not respond.
If you have any information on Zayla's whereabouts, you are urged to please call Crime Stoppers.